Hello and welcome to another of MATLAB Helper's amazing videos on stock market with MATLAB. So in this video, we'll continue our discussion on developing the back end of the stock prediction application. So in the previous video, we saw the starter function, the properties, and a few other callbacks as well that were associated with fetching the historical data and showing it onto the axes. Now in this video, we'll look at how we can employ the regression tools to obtain a regression model that we can use to predict stock prices for future date values. So let's begin by going into the callback that will allow us to select a particular regression type from the drop-down menu. So we'll simply go to that callback, and here we have used a switch case conditional to obtain a short form version of the chosen regression type. Now if the user chooses linear, we are saving lin in the variable app of regression. Now the variable app of regression is the variable that we'll be using in the function regression function later on, and this will determine which algorithm we'll use to find the regression model. Similarly, we have used poly in place of polynomial and non-L in place of non-linear. Alright, so after this, what we'll do is we'll just go and look at the regression button group value changed again. And you will see that when user clicks on the fit data radio button, the regression function is executed. Alright, so we'll just go straight to the function and we'll look at how we can execute the regression here. Alright, so here's the function, the regression function we have here. So I've named the function regr function to represent regression function. Now in the beginning, we are converting or we are saving the date and opening prices in the variables date and open. Now we are saving the POSIX time or unique time values of the date in the variable date, and we are saving the numerical values of the opening price in the variable open. After that, we are checking the value stored in the variable app.reg. Now, depending upon whether it's lin, poly, or non-L, we'll execute our code. All right, if it's lin, then it means that we want to execute a linear regression, right? So what we'll do is we'll use the function polyfit here. Now, polyfit actually fits a polynomial model on our data, but if we choose the order of the polynomial is 1, what we'll obtain is a first order polynomial or a linear polynomial. Alright, so by choosing the order as 1, we can simply obtain a linear regression model. So we are computing the linear regression model for the date as the independent variable and the opening price as the dependent variable. And we are saving the model in the variable app.model, and app.mu will tell the function polyfit that we want to normalize these two variables before we compute the model. Now we need this variable app.mu later on whilst predicting the stock prices as well as whilst plotting the curve for this particular linear regression. Now next on, what we are doing is we are actually using the plot function, plot tool, to plot the curve that we have obtained from the linear regression model. Now, how we can do that? We can actually get the plot by using the function polyval. The polyval uses first of all the model, then the x values. In this case, the x values are the date values, and then we have an empty array which accounts for this term here in the middle. This middle term is actually what we could have used to obtain the regression stats. So for instance, we could have obtained the appropriateness of the fit by getting the R2 score of the fit. Now R2 score actually computes the relative error between the actual data and the data obtained from the module. So that's, if it's equals to 1, then we have a very good model. It's exactly the same as the data, and we desire the R2 score to be as close to 1 as possible. Alright, so We have not used s here, so it's been left blank here. And finally, we have app.mu. App.mu will tell the function polyval that we want to compute the actual graph. We do not want the normalized values here. So using this app.mu, polyval can compute the denormalized values for the opening price. We have kept the date the same as in the date time format here. So we are just plotting the date time dates against the opening prices obtained from the model here. And the rest is simple. So we have held the graph, and then we are again using the plot function to plot the actual data points onto the graph. Now we are doing that using again the plot function as told before, and we are plotting the date against the opening price here. All right, and then we are naming the title of linear regression, and we are labeling the x and y axis, and we are giving it a good legend. We are telling the user that the first curve shows the modeled value or the predicted values, and the second curve gives the actual values. And we are mentioning the location for the legend as the best location possible, so that it does not cover the actual plot, any of the two plots, I mean. Finally, we are holding off the plots over here. Similarly, in the case of polynomial regression, when app.reg is equals to poly, we'll ask, first of all, the user to enter the degree of the polynomial. Now, in the case of linear regression, the degree will always be 1. But in the case of any polynomial regression of degree more than 1, we'll have to ask the user to choose a degree so that the user can choose a model that best fits visually the data. All right, so here we have the function polyfit again, date and open over here, and then we are converting the cell value of values. So this value we obtain will be as a cell array of string. In this case, if someone chooses the value 3, it will be a cell containing the string 3. We are first converting the cell to a matrix and then converting the string in that matrix into a double term. All right, so that's what we're doing here. After that, once we have the numerical value of the degree of the polynomial, we can simply execute the function polyfit and obtain the model and the mu values from here. And then we'll simply use the function plot again here to obtain the curve for the modeled values. The code is just the same over here and the same for the actual values as well. So here the title changes, but the rest remains the same. All right. Finally, we go into the case for the nonlinear regression. Here, things are a bit different. First of all, we normalize the date and opening prices, and we do this here manually because the function that we'll use for nonlinear regression does not automatically normalize the values. So the way we are normalizing it is by dividing the date and opening price by their maximum values, which we have saved in app.mDate and app.mOpen respectively. Thereafter, we'll just display a list dialog box containing the three options from logistic function, square root function, and exponential function. Now, these three are the functions we will allow the user to choose from. Now, these three functions are nonlinear functions that the user can try and fit onto the data that he or she has fetched from the Yahoo Finance website. Once the user has chosen a particular function, will get the value of that function here, and then we can check the string of that function by using the switch case statement again. Now, depending upon the function chosen, we'll define the function app.f. Now, app.f, if it's a logistic function, it will be of the type 1 by 1 plus exponent of x1 into, within braces, date minus x2. Now, x1 and x2 are the two parameters which we intend to find by means of this nonlinear regression, and date is the independent variable that we'll use to find the dependent variable opening price. And x0 here is the initial value of these two parameters. Similarly, we'll define the square root function like this, x1 plus x2, square root of 8. And third, we'll define the exponential function as x1 into exponent of 8 by x2. Now, you can choose any modification of these three functions, and I hope that they will work just fine. You could have also implemented some more, you could say, variables here in x's, such as you could have had x3, x4, to make these functions more generalized, and that would have worked as well, as long as you have the same number of initial variables as you have used in this function. After we have defined the nonlinear functions and their initial values, what we'll do is we'll simply fit the curve by using the function lsqcurvefit. Now, lsqcurvefit stands for least square curve fit. Now, MATLAB uses the trust region based algorithm for this purpose, although there are other options available which you can check out by visiting the MATLAB website, the MathWorks website, I mean. So here we first define the function onto which, or which we actually want to fit onto the available data, and then we'll have x0 as the initial values and date as the independent variable and opening price as independent variable. And we'll get the x or the values of x1 and x2 as the output, and we're saving it in the variable app model. All right. Finally, we are using this model to plot the curve, the model curve. Now we are using again the date time date stored in the hist data variable, and then we are actually using the function app.f to find the y values or the opening price values. So we are just inserting x here and the date term, the POSIX time dates, and multiplying it with app.mopen. So that we obtain the unnormalized values or the denormalized values of the opening prices. So once we have displayed the curve for the modeled data, we can simply plot the actual curve by plotting data against the opening price, the historical data against the historical opening price, I mean, and change the title, and the rest remains the same here again. So as you saw that we have used these two functions to actually carry out the regression problem. The first of all was polyfit and the second one was lsqcurvefit. There's one more function that we could have used, and it's called anlinfit, and it stands for nonlinear fit, and it does just the same as lsqcurvefit, although that function has some other attributes as well. So you could have experimented with that function if you were writing your own code. This is all about the function regression function, and there's one more very small function, or you could say callback, that we have not discussed yet, and that is actually the callback to find the predicted value for a particular chosen date. Alright, so what we'll do here is that we'll simply, again, get the date value from the user and then convert it to a POSIX time or image time format. Thereafter, we'll check the kind of regression that the user had chosen. And depending upon that, we'll either use the function polyval or the function app.f to compute the predicted opening price. Alright, the rest remains the same. What we have done here is, again, if it's either linear or polynomial regression, we'll use the function polyval and use the model app model here, date and new here. All right. And if it's nonlinear, then we'll use the function app.f, which will contain the nonlinear function used. And we'll use the model, which will contain the x values of the parameters. And then we'll use the date term here. I have divided it by n.date because we will normalize the date here whilst using it inside the function, and then we'll denormalize the values by multiplying it with mopen so that we get the denormalized opening values. So we have used normalized date and we have multiplied it with m.open so that we get the denormalized opening prices. Alright, and finally we have displayed the value of the stock price, the opening value, onto the edit field over here. All right. Thereafter, we have the final callback, which is the callback to close the application, the menu actually. So we'll just write delete app in the menu, and whenever the user clicks on the menu, the application will close by itself. That's all in this particular video and in this particular application per se. There are a lot of things that you could have done here, you could have included, and we have discussed more about this in the last lesson of the module 3. So this video concludes our course on stock market application, and I hope that you have all enjoyed the entire course. If anywhere you have found any difficulties or you wish something changed or made better, feel free to inform us about that. And if you have any queries, feel free to ask us via email or in the comment section below.